Hi there, my name is Aleksandra. I'm a singer, songwriter, music producer, and a vocal coach. Today, I'll be analysing Tori Amos. Alongside Kate Bush, Regina Spektor, Tori Amos was one of my biggest influences as an artist. And it's quite likely that it's because of her that I have ginger hair now. All right, but let's have a look at Winter. It's one of my favorite songs by Tori Amos. I'm sure we're gonna have a look at some interesting details together.
This is my last song. This is from my dad. Snow can wait, I forgot my mittens. Wipe my nose, get my new boots on.
Alright, get my new boots on. That breath release there is part of what makes Tori Tori. This is something she does really quite frequently, that breath release. It's part of her style. One other thing that I'm noticing already is the audible breaths. In between of the lines, we really can hear her breath, and she's singing very closely to the mic, which leads me to think that she wants the song to feel very intimate, you know, as if she's whispering to your ear. The song's topic and whom she's singing the song to is her father, is her dad. So it's almost like we as the audience are granted the permission to be able to hear this intimate conversation between both of them.
I get a little warm in my heart when I think of winter. I put my hand in my father's glove. I run off where the drifts get deep.
And we're gonna stop now as well already. The way she used her voice in that first fragment compared to how she sang that first line and how she's going to continue to sing it is very different. So intentionally, she's playing with the color of her voice, with the quality of her voice. She started to sing this song with a bit of a higher sitting larynx. So if you put your three fingers on your larynx here and you sing, snow can wait. As a 5 years old girl, snow can wait, snow can wait. Compare it with snow can wait. That would be a neutral larynx where you normally speak. And now make it really girly, really like a kid speaking. Snow can wait, snow can wait, snow can wait. Snow can wait. Tori's a bit like an actress here, really just having fun with her voice and choosing to portray what she's singing about. She's singing about her past self. She's singing as if she was that 5 years old girl when she sings the song in that first fragment. And then now we are in the present moment, and she lets that voice quality shift to something that's more like her now.
Sleeping Beauty trips me with a frown. I hear a voice, you must learn to stand up for yourself, 'cause I can't always be around. He says, when you gonna make up your mind? When you gonna love you as much as I do? When you gonna make up your mind? 'Cause things are gonna change so fast. All the white horses are still in bed. I tell you that I'll always want you near. You say that things change.
song, this song always makes me tear up a bit. I always feel pretty emotional when I listen to it. Such a beautiful piece of songwriting, and you know, the song is all about finding that self-love, self-acceptance, and she's also talking about this relationship with her father. It's really quite special. In that chorus, she's really mindful of each and every word she's singing about, and she really does know what she wants to say with each line of her song, and that allows her to use these different voice effects, different dynamics. You're gonna sing the same line in a different way depending on if you're desperate, for example, for something, or if the feeling is that of love and care, or maybe it's sympathy, maybe it's anger, maybe it's frustration, maybe you're being flirty. You need to get very clear with yourself in regards of how you want to shape your story for it to be this successful.
Boys get discovered as winter melts, flowers competing for the sun.
All right, so two things here. I loved how she went from mezzo forte, so like mid loud, to really quiet in one line for each of these lines. She's really using the dynamics here. I love it. And she's going, competing for the sun. Really singing on the consonant, singing on the N, and then I'm finishing it off with a bit of vibrato as well. This is just stunning, and not a lot of singers use it as much as they could, especially beginner singers. Use consonants, guys. So your N, your M, and G. If a word finishes on one of these sounds, it's great to sing on it.
Years go by and I'm here still waiting, withering where some snowman was. Mirror, mirror, where's the crystal palace? But I only can see myself skating around the truth, who I am. But I know, Dad, the ice is getting thin.
The ice is getting thin. Again, we had that breath release. And that whole verse is her playing with the dynamics. She's going from loud to quiet, crescendo, decrescendo, crescendo, decrescendo. A great way of practicing it is the exercise called messa di voce, singing one note, going from quiet to loud and back to quiet softly. This is really gonna train your responsiveness, and using the dynamics is a fantastic creative tool.
When you gonna make up your mind? When you gonna love you as much as I do? When you gonna make up your mind? 'Cause things are gonna change so fast. Tell you that I'll always want you near. You say that things change, my dear.
About this fragment here. So after the big instrumental, she decided to switch to the higher octave and sing that bit in her head voice. But what she did to make it more powerful and more punchy, a bit more bright, is to use twang. If you don't know about twang, please watch my video on twang. This is how she's getting that power and that higher range.
On the shelf, you say I wanted you to be proud of me. I always wanted that myself.
Okay. I love that ending. Myself. So really, we're going from something big and powerful, full of emotion, to then she's getting quite retracted into herself. Listen to how her breath behaves just after myself. We can use the breath in between of the lines to achieve a very particular effect. So in singing, ideally, if we want to be neutral, we want the breath to be almost inaudible in between of the phrases. But then, if you have that ability, you can use the breath creatively. And this is, I believe, what Tori's doing here. Listen again.
I always wanted that myself. When you gonna make up your mind? When you gonna love you as much as I do? When you gonna make up your mind?
So beautiful. That first beginning, she was obviously almost whispering with that slightly breathy quality, and she was singing it all in a smile.
When you're gonna make up your mind
is very different to
when you're gonna make up your mind. When you're gonna make up your mind.
We can hear the smile. We can really hear the smile in her singing. This really aids the interpretation. When we smile, the vocal tract gets shorter and that boosts the higher harmonics, and we perceive that sound as brighter. Brain basically knows that you're smiling when you hear that. We have that contradiction almost. She goes for the smile and that warm voice quality, and then she shifts to something that reminds me of a sob, very sad. And the way she shapes her mouth, she goes from smile to vertical and sad. Again, that really shifts her voice quality as well. Let's have a listen.
When you gonna love you as much as I do? When you gonna make up your mind? 'Cause things are gonna change so fast. All the white horses have gone ahead. I tell you that I'll always want you near. You say that things change, my dear. Never change. All the white horses
At the very end, she's just improvising and singing some lines from the song. And to me, it almost sounds like it's echoes from her past. And it's just such a lovely outro. And to think about it in this way, I think, really makes a difference. It was a bit of a trip to nostalgia land. I hope you enjoyed this analysis. And I think we can all agree that it was an extraordinary performance. Please subscribe to this channel if you would like to see some similar videos. You can also find me on social media. You can find me on Instagram and Facebook. I'm also on TikTok. What's more, I lead interactive online courses. One of them is authentic songtelling. If you're a singer and a songwriter who wants to sing in a way that captures people's hearts, like Tori does, have a look at my website. It's alexandravocalcoach.com. I hope to see you here again soon. Bye, guys. Tori is not only a fantastic songwriter, a really good singer, but she's an artist. She's a true artist. And an artist who takes her craft very seriously. I read her biography. She's not only had been learning how to play piano from the very young age, but she also started to take voice lessons from, I think, around the age of 13 or around when she was a teenager. And then she continued that for sure up until her mid-20s. I would hope that she continued when singing became her profession as well. I think that Tori's way of singing, how she delivers the song, sounds very natural in a way. It might sound like it's just effortless, but it's part of her craft. It's part of that dedication, that constant need to improve and to work on your craft. This is what created this beautiful voice. Bear that in mind the next time you don't feel like practicing.